This is Raj
and Niya with your favorite USMLE channel, where we help you gain in-depth understanding of the high-yield USMLE topics and score phenomenal on the steps.
We're teaching medical content for all steps using our own personally crafted mind maps and algorithm that's gonna make concepts stick.
What you can expect in our videos is a lot of integration, as well as getting a clinical perspective of what's truly important to learn.
Hope you enjoy this video.
Please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell button to receive notifications once we upload new videos.
Thank you for watching.
So let's deal with hypercalcemia first. Imagine this is a neuron. Every cell has a resting membrane potential. For the neuron, it's minus 70 millivolts. This potential is determined by the uneven distribution of ions, which means that inside the neuron we have relatively more potassium ions, and outside the neuron we have relatively more sodium ions. In order for this neuron to depolarize, meaning to fire, you need the sodium to come inside the cell. And it does so via this sodium channel. It depolarizes the neuron and the neuron starts firing. Now what happens normally is when you want this process to cease, calcium comes, sits on top of this channel and it blocks it. So it stops the sodium influx. So it stops the depolarization of the neuron. Now in hypercalcemia, you just have too many calcium ions. So this channel will be constantly blocked. So it will be very difficult for the neuron to depolarize. And this is how we explain the physical symptoms. Imagine the nerve cells that are supplying your skeletal muscle. If they're not firing, your muscle won't be contracting. So you will feel weak. Imagine the nerve cells in your brain are not firing. You will feel depressed, confused. Imagine the nerve cells that are innervating the smooth muscles in your gut. If they're not firing, the smooth muscles are not contracting and you end up with constipation. This is how with one phenomena we can explain all these physical symptoms. Cool, right? Let's discuss hypocalcemia now. Again, this is our neuron with resting membrane potential of minus 70 millivolts. But what do you think is going to happen with the sodium channel in hypocalcemia? Yes, it will be constantly open. Why? Because there's just not enough calcium to close it. So there will be constant influx of sodium ions inside our neuron. And what do you think is going to happen with our resting membrane potential? Yes, it will increase from minus 70, let's say it goes up to minus 30 millivolts. This will make the neurons hyperexcitable. That's how we can explain Chwostek sign. So what he would do is, he would tap at the angle of the jaw and he would see this. Why is this happening? Because he's tapping on top of the hyperexcitable facial nerve. And this hyperexcitable nerve needs just a little bit of a tap to depolarize and to fire, thus causing the muscles it's applying to contract. Easy, right? Why would you feel anxious? Imagine the nerve cells in your brain are constantly firing. Yes, definitely would feel anxious and irritable. Now in trousseau sign, we observe constant carpal spasm here by putting a blood pressure cuff and inflating it. Why is this happening? Now in hypocalcemia, you still have a little bit of calcium flowing around. But if you cut the blood supply to your distal arm by inflating this blood pressure cuff, from having less calcium, you end up having no calcium. That's why we see this sustained carpal contraction. And this was the explanation of how hypo and hypercalcemia give you the physical presentation we observe.